Hey guys, for those who didn't know, back when I created this channel, I actually used to be a PokeTuber. So today I'm gonna be going back to my roots a bit and I'm gonna be playing some Pokemon. But not only that, I'm gonna be challenging myself to beat Pokemon FireRed with only Ash's team. And yes, this includes catching all 30 Tauroses. I got inspired by a bunch of PokeTubers like Enter the Unknown and My Dry Bread. And if you haven't already for whatever reason, check them out. With that being said, let's get right into the rules I'll be implementing on myself. I can only use Pokemon from Ash's team, meaning I cannot evolve Pokemon that he hasn't evolved yet, and I also have to catch all 30 Tauroses into Safari Zone. No items in battles, besides held items and of course Pokeballs to catch Pokemon. And I have to put the game in set rules so I wouldn't know what Pokemon would be sent out after beating one, just like in the anime. If you guys enjoy my content, be sure to subscribe since it would really help me out. It's free, and you guys can always unsubscribe later. So without further ado, let's get right into the challenge. After naming myself Ash and my rival Gory, I headed to Professor Oak's lab to grab my first Pokemon to start the challenge. I used the Pokemon Universal Randomizer to replace Squirtle with Pikachu, because I believe that my rival having Bulbasaur will make the challenge a little bit more harder. I actually almost lost my first rival fight, and it was only because of paralyzed luck and a few growls that I actually beat him. This is gonna be a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. On my way to Viridian City, I did some grinding to get some extra levels and I got the parcel. After giving Professor Oak his parcel, I went into Viridian Forest to encounter Caterpie, which is the very first Pokemon Ash has ever caught in the anime. And not very long after that, we caught a Pidgeotto, which doesn't appear in Pokemon FireRed or Leaf Green, but we have our way around things. We started grinding up until all the Pokemon are level 9, where Caterpie would evolve into Metapod and into Butterfree. After grinding up a little bit, I feel pretty confident to battle my rival back at Route 22. I sent out my Pikachu as he sends out his Pidgey, and with a couple of Thundershocks, I was able to knock him out. After Gory sends out his Bulbasaur, I sent out my Pidgeotto to hit him with a few super effective wing attacks, making this a pretty easy win, not gonna lie. I make my way past Viridian Forest to get through Pewter City to get our first badge. I'm kind of afraid of this gym because most of my Pokemon are weak to rock types, and Pikachu legitimately cannot attack any of their Pokemons. I'm gonna have to rely on Butterfree because he has Confusion, and Geodude and Onix aren't really known for their special defense, so this is our game plan for now. Before entering the gym though, I decided to grind up to level 12 to level 13, to at least have a fighting chance with Brock. This is gonna be a massive pain considering all wild Pokemon at this point are around level 2 to level 5. Most of them giving me under 20 experience. At the gym, Butterfree was able to beat the gym trainer with a couple of confusions. Now it's time for Brock. I sent out my Butterfree and he sends out his Geodude. I spam some confusion to knock him out, but he actually hit me with a critical tackle, making me lose a lot of health. After beating Geodude, Butterfree leveled up to level 13, where he learns Poison Powder, which opens up an opportunity for us to beat Brock. As he sends out his Onix, I use Poison Powder so he can lose health throughout the battle. It wasn't long after until he uses Rock Tomb, knocking out my Butterfree. As I sent out my Pidgeotto, I immediately tried stalling by using Sand Attack so that Rock Tombs can miss more often. This was very helpful because Poison was able to chip away at half of Onix's health. And of course, Pidgeotto fainted. You tried your best, buddy. I sent out my Pikachu and tried using Tail Whip to lower his defense and get a couple of quick attacks in to chip away at his health for a little bit. Soon though, poison was too much for him to handle and he faints, getting us the Boulder Badge. It was a team effort that got us this badge. What a battle. I made my way past Mount Moon and along the way I fought trainers, including Team Rocket. And if you guys are asking, yes, I did pick up the Helix Fossil. Before heading to the Nugget Bridge, I head over to the Water Gym to get my second badge. I believe the gym would be pretty easy since I have Pikachu with me, but let's see, despite being underleveled, I took my shot at the gym. As I was going to the gym, I beat all gym trainers with just Pikachu, which made me think beating Misty would be pretty easy. I soon realized that Starmie was way more powerful than I anticipated. It took me about 4 tries until I realized that I needed to grind a little bit more to beat her. Really wishing that I could go to Nugget Bridge right about now. Even after all that grinding, it took us about 2 tries to get the run we needed. I sent in my Pikachu as he sends in her Starmie. It was really easy to take out with a couple of Thundershocks, and in comes her Starmie. I didn't want my Pikachu to take damage right off the bat, so I sent in my Pidgeotto to take a hit. Surprisingly enough, he could survive 3 water pulses with 1 HP, giving me the opportunity to chip away at his health for a bit. Soon enough though, it faints of course, and I sent in my Butterfree, After getting hit by a strong water pulse, I used poison powder so it could chip away at his health for a bit. Surprisingly enough, Butterfree was able to survive another water pulse, defying my expectations. I was able to use a supersonic, but sadly, Butterfree faints. It's all up to Pikachu now. Misty used a super potion, but all that matters is that Pikachu is at full health. I was able to use two thundershocks to get it into red, and poison was enough to knock it out. What an intense battle. Because of all the efforts of the team, I was able to obtain the Cascade Badge. Next is a rival fight, which is pretty straightforward. I used Pikachu to knock out Pidgeotto, Butterfree to knock out Rattata and Bulbasaur, and Pidgeotto to knock out Abra. I make my way to Nugget Bridge and to Route 24, where we will be getting two Pokemon. The first one being Bulbasaur being abandoned for not being able to evolve, and the other one being Charmander being abandoned for being too weak. The nerve of some people. They were pretty underleveled though, so we had to do some grinding. While doing that, we ran into the Squirtle Squad, causing chaos to innocent people. We captured him after helping him out for a bit. We now have a full team, and now we are on our way to Bill's house, where we capture Krabby and immediately send him to Oak's lab. When we got to Bill's house, we decided to help him out after he made a mistake with his experiment. He then rewarded us with the SSN ticket. It's time for us to head to Vermilion City, where we get a third badge, but before doing that, we have to go to the SSN. In the anime, Ash was being a d**k and traded his Butterfree for Eradicate, so I decided to switch those two out for the time being. This means I'll have to catch Eradicate and use it in the SSN. Like Ash though, I didn't really use him that much. We really did Butterfree dirty here. It's time for another rival fight. This again was pretty easy, especially with the new Pokemon we have on our team. Since I was his Pidgeotto, which I immediately take out with Pikachu with a few Thundershocks, his Raticate was no problem with my Squirtle. And Pidgeotto was an absolute beast by knocking out both Ivysaur and Kadabra, getting us the win. We were now able to get the HM we needed to enter the Viridian City Gym. Before that though, I traded back Raticate for my Butterfree back and I apologized to him for being an It's time for me to face the gym. I was able to beat all the gym trainers with relative ease because of Dig on Pikachu. And now it's time to face Lieutenant Surge. As I expected, the battle was pretty quick and easy. I was able to beat both his Voltorb and his Pikachu with just my Pikachu by using Dig. I could have done it with his Raichu, but I got paralyzed and he started using Double Team, making it harder for me to hit him with Digs. It wasn't until I sent out Bulbasaur when I started doing damage to him, with a few Leech Seeds and a couple of Razor Leaves. Either way, this was pretty easy, and I got the Thunder Badge because of it. On our way to Lavender Town, Butterfree finds a pink Butterfree. They decided to become mates and we decided it is better for him if he left the team to be with her. You won't be forgotten, Butterfree. Thank you for being on our team. I make it past Rock Tunnel and immediately went to the Pokemon Tower for our rival battle. This again was pretty easy. I was able to knock out Pidgeotto with one Thunderbolt from Pikachu. I don't think crit mattered, and for some reason he sends out his Gyarados, which I easily took out with one Thunderbolt. The AI in this game is pretty weird, dude. He sends out his Growlithe and I was able to take it out with my Squirtle. With a few water pulses, of course. And so his Ivysaur and I sent out my Pidgeotto and my Charmander to knock it out, since for some reason he decided to go to sleep. He then sends out his Kadabra, which I was able to knock out with Charmander with one critical Rock Slide. And yes, that crit did matter. Now it's time for us to go to Celadon City. On the way there, we ran into a Mankey, causing trouble for me and my team. We decided to capture it and it evolved into a Primeape. In the anime, Ash fought Serena first, but because it's physically impossible to do that in Pokemon FireRed, we decided to go for Erika's gym. Right off the bat, we defeated all the gym trainers because of Charmander's Ember, later turning into Flamethrower, which would be a huge help in the future. Now it's time for Erika, and as I predicted, this battle was pretty easy because of Pidgeotto and Charmander. I used Pidgeotto to knock out Tangela, and I used Charmander to knock out both Vileplume and Victory Bell, earning us a Rainbow Badge. This has to be the easiest badge we obtained so far. It's time for us to go to the Team Rocket hideout. I beat all the grunts with relative ease without any problem, and then I see the boss of Team Rocket. The Giovanni battle was an absolute joke. He sent out Onyx, which Bulbasaur was able to knock out with one Giga Drain. And for some reason, he thought it would be a good idea to send out Rhyhorn, which once again, my Bulbasaur was able to hit with one Giga Drain. Tried using him to beat Kangaskhan, but RNG was not on my side. I missed Sleep Powder and I got Flinch. Twice! Kangaskhan eventually knocked out Bulbasaur, but Primeape made easy work with Kangaskhan with a few Karate Chops, winning the battle. After getting the Silph Scope, we decided to go to the Pokemon Tower. We decided to help our Marowak by putting her soul to rest, and we helped Mr. Fuji from Team Rocket. After doing this, we head to Saffron City to face Sabrina for our next badge. Little to find out that the whole town was compromised by Team Rocket, so we head to Silph Co. to once again stop their plans, and to grind up for the gym, we decided to grind up on a Rocket Grunt. After After beating all the grunts in Silph-Co, I felt pretty confident for a rival battle. It wasn't long after this that I realized that I was pretty underleveled to beat my rival. We did some grinding and I even used some rare candies that I got throughout the journey. It's time to try this again. This was the round we needed to beat Gory. He sends out his Pidgeot and I send out my Pikachu, which I was able to take out with 2 Thunderbolts. He for some reason takes out his Gyarados, which I was able to take out with 1 Thunderbolt. Once again, the AI in this game is pretty weird. After I sent out Growlithe, I tried using Dig to chip away at his health for a bit, but it didn't happen and he knocked out my Pikachu. I sent in my Squirtle and he takes out his Growlithe with 1 Water Pulse. He then sends in his Venusaur. I kept Squirtle in because I didn't want Charmander or Pidgeotto to lose health. He then one-shots my Squirtle with 1 Razor Leaf. Of course, right? It's Pidgeotto's time to shine. I used 3 wing attacks to knock out Venusaur and 2 to knock out Alakazam, winning us the battle. I honestly didn't think the levels would spike up this much. I should have grinded up a little bit more and done a little more research. That aside, it is time to face Giovanni once again. He sends in his Nidorino and I send out my Bulbasaur. Knowing this is a bad match for me, I tried switching out, but before that I used Sleep Powder and Leech Seed, and I sent in my Pikachu to use Dig on him. It didn't faint, but 1 shot of Thunderbolt was able to knock it out. He then sends in his Nidoqueen. I used Dig once again, but it didn't do that much damage, and he knocked me out with a Body Slam. So I sent out my Squirtle to take it out with 3 Water Pulses. It is now time for Kangaskhan. As I expected, Kangaskhan was able to knock out Squirtle. I sent in my Pidgeotto so I could do some chip damage, and I used Whirlwind so Reach doesn't build up. This is insane. I sent in my Primeape to sack him off, but he was actually strong enough to beat both Rhyhorn and Kangaskhan by spamming some Karate Chops. Despite being 9 levels under his opponent, he was able to beat them. What a f***ing legend. Now it's time for us to face Sabrina, who I'm actually kind of afraid of because Psychic types are really overpowered in this generation. Before doing that though, I head to the game center to get Ice Beam and taught it to my Squirtle. It's time to take on the gym. I beat all their gym trainers thanks to Pidgeotto's physical moves, and now it's time to face Sabrina. And surprisingly enough, it wasn't that hard as I expected it to be. I sent out my Charmander and she sent out her Kadabra, which I was able to take out with 3 Rock Slides without taking damage. She takes out her Mr. Mime and immediately starts setting out buffs. I was actually getting scared until she uses Baton Pass into Venomoth, which I was able to knock out with 2 Flamethrowers. I don't know why she didn't just send in Alakazam, because I'm pretty sure that's a better play here, but whatever. I'll take it. Later on, Mr. Mime shared the same fate. She sends out her Alakazam, which is a Pokemon I was worried about. I use Slash and I immediately get taken out by 1 Psychic. I sent in my Squirtle to chip away at her health with a few bites and she takes me out, of course. And then I sent in my Pidgeotto, finally ending the fight with a few wing attacks, getting us a Marsh Badge. I guess I was scared for no reason. This wasn't that bad. Before going to Fuchsia City to get our next gym badge, I decided to go to the fighting dojo to honor Primeape. Sadly though, he decided to become a fighter after watching Jake Paul's fight, so we had to leave him so he could follow his dreams. I know it wasn't long, but thanks for being a part of our team. We are back at 5 Pokemon, but luckily for us, it's almost time to go to the Safari Zone. I ran through the cycling road and made my way to Fuchsia City. I make it to Fuchsia City and I try finding the gym immediately. After fighting all the gym trainers with ease, it's time to battle Koga. His mug was a major pain because of his Minimize and Acid armor. In fact, it took me about 3 tries to beat him. It took the effort of the whole team, but we were able to beat him. It was thanks to Pidgeotto and his Whirlwinds where we were able to beat him and obtain the Soul Badge. Before leaving Fuchsia City, I decided to go to the Safari Zone, and every time I try catching a new Pokemon, it's always Tauros. Not only one, but 30 of them. Before that, I decided to get Surf and the Golden Teat, and now it's time to suffer. And as you can tell from my tone, it took me just a while to get one. Getting 30 of them is gonna be f***ing insane. I ended up getting frustrated, so I sped up the emulator. Even then did it take a while. So I did a bit of catching off camera, and here's all 30 of them in the box. Please, for your own sanity, never do this. This was not worth it at all. I decided to keep one on my team just because of all the hard work it took just to catch them all. I'm gonna use one. I got the HM for strength and I decided to make a little detour to route 15, 14, 13, and 12 to grind up Tauros up to level 40. I then decided to go to the power plant before going to Cinnabar Island. In the anime, Ash and his friends went to Grinky City. And if you guys don't know where that is, I can't really blame you since it's not in the game. And in the anime, they were having power problems thanks to a Muk and a bunch of Grimers. Despite that, Muk became one of his valuable team members. After that, I went to Route 19 to finally get to Cinnabar Island. On our way there, Charmander evolved into Charmeleon and into Charizard. As excited as I am to have a Charizard, he doesn't actually listen to Ash much, so I'm gonna have to limit my use of him. which kinda sucks. We make it through the Seafoam Islands, we made it to Cinnabar Island and explored the Pokemon Mansion since the gym is locked, in hopes to find a key in there to open the gym. Now it's time to face a gym, and it was pretty easy considering Squirtle was able to spam Surf. The gym trainers were kind of a joke. It's time to face Blaine, and I actually sent out my Charizard for the memes, and also because Ash actually uses him in his anime battle against him. Charizard almost actually ended up sweeping his team. He just destroyed his Ponyta, Growlithe, and Rapidash with just a few Rock Slides. I tried doing the same with his Arcanine, but minus 2 was just a little too much for me, so I sent in my Squirtle to knock him out with one Surf, earning us the Volcano Badge. What an easy battle. It's time for Giovanni, and this is pretty straightforward. I head to Viridian City to face the final gym. I was able to beat all the gym trainers with relative ease, and now it's time for Giovanni. And as I expected, this battle was pretty easy. Bulbasaur was able to take out Rhyhorn and Dugtrio using Giga Drain, while Squirtle was able to take out Nidoqueen, Nidoking, and another Rhyhorn. It's time to head to the Elite Four. Before getting to Victory Road, Gory rudely interrupted me, and we ended up battling. Pikachu was able to knock out his Pidgeot, Bulbasaur was able to knock out his Rhyhorn, Tauros was able to knock out his Alakazam with relative ease, Pidgeotto took out his Growlithe, and Charizard took out his Venusaur and Gyarados. What an intense battle, it literally took us the entire team. We definitely need to grind up a little bit before challenging the Elite Four. I got past Victory Road, and now it's time to face the Elite Four. I immediately tried doing the Elite Four, but then I realized that I needed to do a little bit of grinding. We try again at level 56, and of course it goes a lot smoother than before. For Lorelei, I used Tauros to knock out Dugong, Pikachu to knock out Cloyster and Lapras, Bulbasaur to knock out Slowbro, and Charizard to knock out Nicki Minaj. For Bruno's battle, I used Bulbasaur to knock out Onix and Hitmonchan, Pidgeotto to knock out Hitmonlee, Charizard to knock out Machamp, and Tauros to knock out his other Onix. For Agatha, I actually sweeped her whole team with just Charizard. Goes to show that evolving your Pokemon actually does you wonders if you want to be Pokemon Master. For the final League 4 Lance, I used Pikachu to knock out Gyarados and Dragonite, Tauros to knock out his two Dragonairs, and Squirtle to take out his Aerodactyl. This by far was the hardest battle yet, and it was only thanks to a few sacrifices was I able to beat him. Now, it's time for the Pokemon League champion, the person we've been rivals with all along. Gory. I sent out my Pikachu as he sends out his Pidgeot, and I was able to take it out with two Thunderbolts. He sends in his Rhyhorn and I send in my Bulbasaur, which I took care of with one Giga Drain. So far, so good. Gory sends out his Alakazam, which absolutely destroyed my Bulbasaur, Tauros, and Pidgeotto with just Psychic. This is absolutely terrifying. I sent in Charizard to take it out with one Flamethrower, and in response, he sends in Gyarados. I sent in Squirtle and I saw Dragon Rage, which I was expecting him to use, so I sent in Pikachu to try taking it out with a Thunderbolt. But sadly, that didn't work and it destroyed me with Hydro Pump. Thanks to some weird AI, I was able to knock out Gyarados by spamming Rock Slide. He sends in his Arcanine, which I was able to knock out with a few Serps from Squirtle. Now it's his last Pokemon, Venusaur. He knocks out his Squirtle and now it's a 1v1. I'm one Fire Blast away, and I won. I won the challenge. All the hard work of catching all 30 Tauruses and grinding up paid off. Though it was a really hard battle late game because of how fragile most of my Pokemon were due to not being able to evolve, it was still extremely fun to challenge myself like this. And I would definitely love to do a similar challenge like this. So if you guys have certain challenges you want me to do, please be sure to comment down below. Thanks for watching me suffering, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.